Okay, so this is going to be a basic setting up a stair-step value scale for the next exercise we're going to do, next project we're going to do. And that's where you're going to control the values slightly more than just the light side, dark side. Clearly the light and dark side has to be established first, but then you're going to have a variation in steps. And if you can establish clearly the steps from white to the darkest dark you can make with your pencil, then you'll have a way of controlling how the values will relate in your drawings. Okay, so you want to set up not a really big value scale. You want to set it up where you're going to have approximately a little over half an inch for each space, and just very, very lightly lay down where your values are going to be and put 9 steps. I'm going to have to stop and count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And we're working on better paper here because your paper quality will make a difference in how well your graphite's received. And so on typing paper, it's a little too slippery. And what you want to do is establish a clear tonal steps, okay? And the simplest way to do that is to do controlled straight hatching, which is straight lines, and do it very, very lightly in the first step because it's just one step up from pure white of the page. And you want to carry that tone all the way up the entire value scale. So this is about as exciting to watch as sand. It's not exciting. This is just about patience, and shading requires a tremendous amount of patience. And so it just goes on and on. So you're going to take this value, and again, I'm actually kind of rushing this for this video, because it's going to take a little bit of time, all right? And I'm probably not going to complete the whole thing because you'll fall asleep. All right, so what I'm going to do is try to establish enough of it so you can see the process. So you can see I'm barely holding my pencil, I'm holding it near the back so that it's just lightly passing over the paper, and I'm trying to keep the lines consistently moving, and I'm allowing those lines to slightly cross over from one step to the next so that I just established a pretty clear tone. Now that's not even the first value. That's just one direction of hatching. So I'm going to go slightly shifting the direction. So if I was going this way, now I'm going to go slightly different in direction. So each time you want to change the direction a little bit, but you don't want to change it too much because if you go like this, it'll be almost impossible to smooth that out. So you want to just slightly change direction. And when you do that, it fills in most of the little tiny gaps. So when you have this tendency to want to use a blending stump or your finger, that's the best way to mess up the tones. It'll actually smudge it. Now, I've seen people using brushes, which can work. And it depends on the type of paper, because if you don't have the right kind of paper, if it's not smooth enough, that's probably not going to work very well either. So again, just slightly changing direction gives you a really smooth tone, and you also have to have a sharp pencil. So, you know, about halfway through this, I'm going to have to probably sharpen the pencil, which I try to avoid that with this because pencil sharpeners on the other side of the room, not so good. Should have been more prepared, should move the pencil sharpener over here. Okay, so again, continuing up, because I want to get the value step, what you have to have is a clear step from one value to the next. And that's the tricky part about this, is, you know, establishing it to where there's a clear value step. Yeah, I just messed that up a little bit. All right, so now you can, well, it's still, and you can darken this just a little more. So I'm going to go slightly different direction. Try and fill in all those little gaps and then carry that up. Because if I carry it all the way up, that way I just have to add to. So it's a very, it's an additive process. I just keep adding to the next value. So the whole area above it is already that value. I'm just going to darken it more. And that's really the way it works in shading. You're going to build these values up. Now there's some tricks to establishing some of your darker areas first, but for this exercise, it's just about establishing a value scale, and it takes pretty much a whole class period to do. do that if you do it right. Some people go a little faster. And it also depends on how big you make these squares. Okay, so now I'm going to start the next step up. And what I'm going to do is shift it to where I'm going to put just a little bit more pressure on the pencil. But you start to see the separation from this step to the last one. And as you can see, the step from the first step into white, it has to be enough of a step to where you put a highlight on there, it's going to stand out. But it has to be an even tone across the whole space. That's why the tendency to want to smudge it is there, but it really doesn't help. Because what that does is it presses the graphite down into the paper and makes it impossible to make any changes to it. So it can't be corrected, and if it's slightly irregular, there's no way to smooth it out. So that's why it's best to avoid that and keep the texture of the paper throughout the drawing. Press down too hard with a pencil, it smushes the paper down, and then it won't actually accept the graphite as well, or at all. It becomes too slick, it won't work. Okay, so, slowly building that up. I'm still using the 2B pencil that I have. It's still not quite enough. You gotta have a clear separation. So I'm gonna hit one more time. Trying to just carry it right on up to the next step, so not having any of these lines, value shifts. It has to just be a smooth value. Okay, that's what I said. This takes a lot of patience to really make this work. Again, one last time. I'm carrying it past the outer edge because that's going to get cut off. In the end, when this is done, we're actually going to cut it out and use it to hold up to your subject and figure out what value each area is relative to the scale. It's not quite dark enough, I may have to come back and change it. So again, I'm going to start pressing a little bit harder to try and create that next separation. Because there has to be a clear separation on each step. Clear contrast, should I say. I'm using the wrong word there. It's about having contrast. Contrast from one value to the next, where you can see the steps shifting from your lightest light to the darkest dark. I'm actually going to kind of set the border there. Now I'm actually rounding the movement of the pencil a little bit to just soften some of that area up, bring it up just a little bit, but you know, getting away from the exact pattern and still keeping it consistent. Okay, so this is number 5, and this should be mid-value on the value, so it's going to be relatively darker gray, and I've got to leave room to have steps at the top. There's got to be another 4 steps after this, so it can't go too dark, but it has to be dark enough compared to the bottom. So what's going to happen at this point, though, I'm probably going to go to the top and carry that down with a 6B pencil as dark as I can take it, and then work in reverse. Okay, so that being said, and this is where it's really critical to have a very sharp pencil, because it's going to give you a lot better tone with a sharp pencil. So I'm actually going to kind of carry these down at least. I'm going to start with the 6B pencil. I'm going to go up once from here. You can see the 6B pencil is a much softer pencil. But it's also going to smear pretty easy, so you have to be careful when you're working with it. And usually work, you know, towards yourself and not, don't be dragging your hand across that area. And I would always work with a piece of paper over, under my hand while I'm working, generally when I'm shading, to keep my hand from getting oil on the paper and also from smearing it. So, just leave that down. So again, I keep that here while I'm working. So again, I'm gonna just get one more value here with the 6B. So that one clearly established. I may even go down slightly into that fifth value. Probably just a little bit here, because most of these lower ones will probably have to be darkened just a little bit. Don't want to do is draw a line in between each one. It has to be the tone that creates the edge, not a pencil line. Okay, so this is where I'm going to really focus on the top and start to put a little more pressure, but what you don't want to do is really press down on your pencil, because again, it's going to flatten out the paper, give a shine to it, and it won't receive the graphite anymore, and it'll actually make it hard to look at and see the tones. So you just want to build it up over time. I keep rotating my pencil too, because I can feel the graphite starting to tighten up, not want to release. I have to speed this up just a little bit. This probably isn't going to be as dark as it needs to be, but this will give you the general idea of how to get to it. But it's going to take a little bit longer than the time I have to record right now. But you can see the values being established. I need a pencil sharpener. Switch pencils. Normally when I'm shading, I'm going to have at least 3 or 4 pencils ready, so that I don't have to stop and sharpen pencils while I'm trying to work on this. But the key here now is to get to establish the darkest dark you can get with your pencil without destroying the paper. And again, that's going to depend a lot on the paper, okay, and on how sharp your pencil is. And again, you can constantly change in direction until you feel like you have space as dark as it can go. Okay. So So again, I want to bring these down just a little bit because there needs to be a separation. And this is where it gets tricky. It is not easy to make sure you have 9 steps. Okay? So this is the best I'm going to be able to do for the time I have and for sharpness of the pencils. So that's what you're going to do. This white is number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now, with a little more time, I could probably bring that whole thing down slightly more in value, but for the time I have right now, that's what we're going to work with. Okay?